Hi, my name is Antonis and I am the iconographer of this video. Thank you for visiting my channel, for subscribing, for commenting and for your interest in the content that I upload. I'm glad that you become better iconographers by watching these videos and I'm always happy to read your comments, answer your questions and see your progress. Today we will discuss about Byzantine buildings and how to paint them. In iconography, buildings are a very important element. They are part of the story that we paint and we depict. And they play a role to make this scene more clear to the viewer and to the narration of the story. Buildings in iconography do not follow any rules of perspective. Perspective was reinvented in the early Renaissance period. We have frescoes from Pompeii that follow the rules of perspective in the Roman period, but after that it was abandoned and it was a need to be reinvented by the Renaissance artists. Anyway, in the Byzantine tradition, iconographers do not follow any rules of perspective, although let's say for the 16th century iconographers knew what was happening in Italy and knew the contemporary paintings that followed the rules of perspective. But even so, they are not interested and they continue painting buildings and the scene in general without following any of these conventions. So we see buildings that their furthest part is bigger than their closest. That's a reverse perspective, and in general they don't follow any of the rules. In my opinion, these buildings are very charming. It's as if they come out of a fairy tale story. They're really, really wonderful. Here you see me painting already some buildings, just to demonstrate how I paint them. First, I'm painting the background, in case you have to paint the buildings on a board. You have to gild the icon first, place the gold leaves first. Anyway, here in this case I just paint my background black, as we have cases in some murals in monasteries of the 16th and 15th century. So I paint on top of this background. I'm starting painting my buildings. You have to remember that each building consists of mainly of two proplasmi: the proplasmos of the light and the proplasmos of the dark. At this point you see me painting a cylindrical building, So I'm not going to use two proplasmi, I'm just going to use one proplasmos. But in this little house here, you see me painting its dark proplasmos as well. Buildings are easy to paint. They don't require any extra effort for to paint any facial characteristics, any expressions. So it's easier than painting other parts in iconography. But they also have their tricks and their tips. It's nice to be more painterly when we paint them. Many times we have these elements of, let's say, curtains in the buildings, or pieces of clothes hanging from one roof to the other. Let me know if you know the meaning of these clothes hanging. I suppose they are to symbolize some festivities going on in the scene, or maybe signifying a palace or an important building. The roofs of the buildings that we normally paint are colored either clay red or dark green most of the times. After we paint, we fill the gesso with our two proplasmi, as I said, the dark and the light proplasmos of each building. Then we start with our grapsimata, defining our shadows and our the edge of the building. Try to make these grapsimata consistent. And in a way that is explanatory to the building. In this case, like in many others in iconography, Γραψίματα are very important and maybe more important than the φωτίσματα, the lighting part. If you paint them correctly and in a nice attentive way, then most of your job is done. They should take more time to paint than the φωτίσματα. So take your time and be more attentive to the γραψίματα. Γραψίματα are not as impressive when we paint an icon. The icon takes form and volume when we paint the light on it, so many iconographers do not pay much attention. But the better you paint the γραψίματα, the better your icon will finally look. So in my opinion, γραψίματα are more important than the φωτίσματα, the light part. And again, use the Cretan way, let's say, of shadowing with tiny thin lines, as you see here. The color is liquid and transparent enough, and the brush is a good Kolinsky brush, so it permits this painting of thin, fine lines. For this demonstration, I follow the some buildings that Theophanes the Cretan has painted in one of the Meteora monasteries, the monastery of Saint Nicholas Anapafsas, and he has painted there some magnificent buildings. Here I paint a second layer of a little darker γράψιμο. Many of you send on my email photographs of your work. Many of you ask me for some online tutorials and courses that I offer, and it's really nice to see that you become better and you progress. Feel free to forward me photos of your artwork and to let me know how helpful these videos are for you. I try to not withhold anything. I don't withhold anything, at least on purpose. I try to give you all my tips when I'm painting. And I'm very rewarded when you say that these videos are helpful. It's also nice when you give me ideas for future videos about what you would like me to paint and what would you like to make a video about. I don't normally rotate my board. I try to teach myself how to paint without rotating it, but sometimes it's very tempting to rotate and paint how it feels more comfortable. So don't think twice, just rotate your board as you like and as it feels comfortable to you. Again, I'm painting here with fine thin lines, the darker part of the proposmos of the building. I see that I could have painted my darker proposmos a little bit darker. It seems that it could be a tone or two darker than it is here. The shadowy part of the building, I mean. Anyway, there are many Italian icons of the 12th, of the 12th, the 13th centuries, the late medieval or the early Renaissance period, and the buildings there look a lot like Byzantine buildings. These are very beautiful icons, and I'm really intrigued to paint in that style as well. Please, an advice that I like to give to my students is to be open in several painting styles, to not constrict themselves to just the Byzantine painting, because every painting style can make us better in iconography. Experiment in painting from nature, experiment painting a portrait of a family member or a friend of yours, experiment why not with abstract art, see how the color behaves and interacts to one next to the other. Be open and see what you can learn and apply in iconography. Technology, of course, is part of our lives today. As you see, I'm still painting the grapsimata and the shadowy parts of the building here. And now I am about to paint my first photisma. So for the first photisma of the building, I take the light proplasmos of the building and I add some white. I want this first photisma to be two or three tones lighter than the proplasmos. I want this first photosma to be significantly darker than pure white, but much lighter than my proplasmos. I'm going to use two photismata, two lights. This first one that you see me, and one with almost pure white. Of course, the variety of buildings in the history of iconography is huge. Here you just see me painting a basic building. Many buildings have decorations, some buildings have faces on them. The way they depict the tiles on the roofs varies. So you should always pay attention to the reference that you have and try to see how the iconographer there has depicted the scene and the buildings. Here is just a demonstration and the basic rules on how to paint the buildings. Of course, like in any other case, the brush is very important. In my opinion, you should use in almost everything a natural hair brush, just for the hard work you should use something else, something like a synthetic brush. Or maybe when you paint larger surfaces like proplasmi. But in general, when you paint graphismata, photismata, detailed work, you should use, in my opinion, a natural Kolinsky brush. It's really helpful and it's more enjoyable. Iconography is an activity that should be enjoyable. It cannot be otherwise. We spent many hours in front of the easel, and we should have a good time. Some people tell me that iconography has saved them from anxiety attacks, panic attacks, depression, and me myself, I feel that iconography is very helpful on this. when you follow your talent or your charisma, then you battle anxiety and depression much more. Anyway, here you see me now painting my second light. This is with pure white. So for the first light of each building, I take proplasmos of each building and add some white. For example, for my bluish building, the first light is bluish. For my greenish, building, the first light is greenish. And for my pink building, my first light is pinkish. The second light, though, it's pure white for all three of them. In some cases, you can blend the first light to the proplasmos with a more liquid, transparent application of color on the edge. Take your time, do not be in a hurry. And try to feel how these buildings should be lit. In many cases, our reference does not give us information. Either because the photograph is not of high quality, or because there might be some areas that are destroyed on these on the icon that we refer from. In those cases, we have to think ourselves how the iconographer must have painted and how to fill the gaps ourselves in a nice, correct way. And of course, we can always use references that are of high quality and they are not destroyed. And this way to fill the gap when needed. And for the tiles, as in the buildings, I first paint my graphsimata. I divide the roof in tiles that make sense, and then I paint my graphsimata and my photismata, as you see here. I am glad to see that most beginner iconographers are doing good with buildings. They are not as clumsy. as when they paint, say, mountains or clothes, etc. So this was my tutorial on buildings. I really hope that you'll find this course helpful and interesting, and feel free to ask anything you'd like below. Please do subscribe if you find this helpful, and more videos are about to come, and more discussions on iconography and iconographers. Again, thank you so much. Have a blessed week. Bye.